On this episode of DIMWIT, we smash pumpkins, talk movies, eat worms, and more. So stay tuned.
There's only decaf in hell, and only coffee, mate, to go with it. The only bread in hell is white Wonder Bread without the crust. Day old. There's only margarine in hell. The only vegetable is lima beans. There are only Pepsi products in hell. Tofu is the only protein source in hell. The only beer you'll find in hell is Pabst Blue Ribbon. Warm. There is a swimming pool in hell. Closed for the season. Hell imports its toilet paper from Israel. The only cartoon you'll see in hell is the Smurfs, and the only TV series is Alf. And the only book is the Driver's Ed Manual. There's only Muzak in hell. And the only color in hell is hot pink. And the only instrument in hell is the bagpipes. There are only pennies in hell. There are only automatic transmissions in hell. And all the drivers are old men. There's only foreplay in hell.
When them guns outside, little bitch, you better be ready. When them guns outside, little bitch, you better be ready. When the stars align, little bitch, you better be ready. I won't take my time, little bitch, you know.
Yeah, like 130, 140. You got it.
Nice par.
Decided to go out of focus, but
I hate pumpkins.
Scared? Lost?
Where'd your parents go?
It's okay. It's okay.
You know what's about to happen. Diet Coke. I definitely should put them in all at once. This is called There Are People Without Food in the World. I'm using it on a bit that doesn't even work. I should have done like a clickbait thumbnail.
Make sure you can see the logos, yeah. I think you gotta take a sip.
Minty.
It's like crime scene.
Dimwit and an imbecile. I blow my nose in your general direction.
That's not in there.
I'm Blue Bart Simpson, and I watched a horror movie every day in October. Well, not actually.
31 movies in 31 days. Did we do it? No. But did we almost do it? Yes. So here are my top 3 movies from watching almost 31 horror movies for all of October.
Coming in at number 3 is Scream. The 1996 movie by Wes Craven. It doesn't really need an introduction. I feel like everyone kind of knows Scream. But I hadn't seen it. I was very, very pleasantly surprised. It's a very good horror movie. And it's meta without being annoying about it. Which was very refreshing, because I feel like every time I see a movie that tries to be meta or self-referential, it's the most annoying, cringeworthy thing. The performances all kind of knew what they were doing, embraced kind of like, you know, the cheese factor, but also knew when it had to be scary. I don't know. Either way, I really enjoyed Scream. It might have birthed a new genre of insufferable horror movies, but it was good on its own. So there you go.
Number 1, and it breaks my heart to announce this, but Eraserhead was so good. I hate David Lynch. I really do. But he did such a good job just making a world that is terrifying and absurd. And you're watching this and it has some of the best effects I've seen in any horror movie anytime recently. I mean, like, obviously newer movies have better effects, but just the costumes and the baby and everything, like, it just looks so eerie. Does such a good job. Everything is composed in such a way that works so well in this world that he creates. And while I hate the story because David Lynch can't make a story that's worth my time, I just love the acting. I love the way the characters interact with each other. I was genuinely so scared of parts of it. Shout out to my boy Jack Nance for doing an amazing acting job.
Number two for me was Climax, the 2018 movie by Gaspar Noé. This movie, you don't really need to know much going into it. It's Gaspar Noé. I saw it Irreversible, so I knew that it was going to be a ride, and it was a ride. It was pretty intense, and you kind of just there for the whole time, and you doesn't really let go at any point. There's moments of, you know, insane choreography. It's like so disorienting. It wears its influences on its sleeve in the best way possible. I wouldn't say I had a good time with it, but I don't regret watching it. I felt like I didn't feel like, you know, a different person when the movie ended, but it took a lot, and in a way where the screen turns to black and you're just thinking about what you just watched. It's not for everybody, but if you're looking for a wild ride, then Climax is your guy.
Number two, The Witch. OMG, I love Robert Eggers. That man is a genius. He's beautiful. It's some of the best monologues I've heard in a movie in a while. Love Anya Taylor-Joy. She cannot be in a bad movie except Glass. But also shout out to Harvey Scrimslaw. He did such a good job. He's such a young actor, and he did a beautiful job just portraying like how it would look for someone to be like possessed and dying. I genuinely was like feeling my heart break watching that movie. It was so good, so hashtag relatable. She's so me.
The third movie I'm gonna talk about, and my favorite one of October, was House. This movie is just wild. It's about these group of girls that find this house, and not everything is what it seems. It's a ton of fun. There's so many effects and transitions and different styles of camera work in it that it looks like the presets that like I scroll through on cameras like this. It works and it makes a movie that's just so enjoyable and entertaining. And it can be pretty freaky too. Don't get me wrong. The special effects are also pretty impressive too. And it just makes for a great all-around movie. The soundtrack slaps too, so it has that. If you're looking for something, a movie unlike many others, then House is a good bet.
And of course, number three, I'm gonna have to go with Possession. Possession literally made it into my top four on Letterboxd. Shout out Letterboxd. Possession was such a good movie. It has some of the best lines. I've just like hitting me in my heart. Like it feels it like a poem. Shout out to French people for making Possession. Like the line, "You say I for me," is just beautiful because it's talking about like the relationship between this man and this woman and how she feels so trapped. And the effects are also great. Like you just feel horrified at times. You're like, I don't want to look at this thing. OMG. Really, really good movie. Really scary. Really relatable. Love movies. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe.
Raw was insane. Rocky Horror Picture Show. You know what that is. Because everyone's having a fun time. I can see why it is the cult classic it is. Texas Chainsaw, the original one. Enjoyed myself here a lot too. You can really feel the heat and filth seeping through. Probably one of my favorite, you know, in like the classic horror movie circle. Onibaba. This one just looks beautiful. It's black and white, Japanese. The look of it, the cinematography, can just trump a lot of other qualms you might have with the movie. Evil Dead 1,
was one of the first ones we watched, and everyone kind of prefaces Evil Dead 1 with,
it's like the second one, but not as good.
Which, like, yeah, but it's still very, very good. The tree scene's a little weird. Sam Raimi at his prime and his heyday, trying to prove himself. Blood everywhere. I enjoyed it a lot, Evil Dead 1. And then a special shout out to Over the Garden Wall.
Oh, gee.
Big wind brand gummy worms. How many can he eat before he gets physically sick? If only y'all could smell this.
It smells like chalk.
No, you're crazy. It smells like candy. It smells like what it is.
We got 84 gummy worms here.
I'm saying, hey, I'm shooting for the stars. I'm saying I do the whole thing.
I think you can do... I'm saying, like, a bag and a quarter.
Okay, so that's...
Maybe a bag and a half.
So, like...
I'll say... 57.
57.
One worm!
I'm feeling good. 10 in. I'm starting to think maybe my goal of everything was a little high, but that's not gonna stop me from pushing on.
Oh, come on.
Already feeling like the sugar seep into my skin and going strong.
28 down.
These things are very sugary. And
gelatinous.
I can feel them taking up a lot of space in my stomach right now. But I'm only 20 deep.
30. Gummy worms.
I hate to let the DIMWIT community down, but I don't know if I'll be able to finish this entire thing by myself. If I move my body, I feel the mass of gum inside me shift.
Gumwit.
I'm feeling pretty physically sick, but I'm gonna keep going until I feel really physically
sick. Throw her away. Yeah.
I'm feeling pretty damn physically sick right now.
He laid down. It's official.
We like to push the boundaries. We like to go west. But sometimes you realize... maybe the expectations you set for yourself are too high.
Please stop pretending we're gonna get home.
Sister.
Just the same.